Hello everyone, and welcome to the third part of the Imperix ACG SDK Getting Started Guide. This video is dedicated to the experimental validation of the control of a buck converter that we've developed in the first two parts. In particular, we will see how to build a converter prototype with Imperix power modules and how to operate a B-Box RCP controller with the code that is automatically generated from our previous Simulink model. The converter will be built with a PEB8038 half-bridge module connected to a DC voltage source and passive components. As in the simulation in Part 2, the measured quantities are the input and output voltages and the output current. The input voltage and output current will be measured by the embedded sensors of the power module, whereas the output voltage will be measured with an Imperix external voltage sensor. The only input to the system is the firing signal for the upper and lower switches. The equipment used is mounted in this cabinet and contains one B-Box RCP controller, one Type-C closed rack with six half-bridge power modules from which we will use only one module, and the passive filter box from which we'll use only one inductor. This equipment is included in the power electronics bundle kit. On the rear side, the output voltage is measured by the external voltage sensor, and the load components are connected to the output of the converter. On the front side, the PWM signal is output on the first optical lane of the B-Box RCP and connected to the power module, and the measurements are connected to the first three analog inputs of the controller. Speaking of the analog front end of the B-Box RCP, it needs to be configured according to the sensor parameters and the operating voltage and currents. The parameters to consider here are the sensor sensitivity and the configuration of the channel input impedance, the analog scaling gain, and the operating limits of the measured quantity. At any time and indefinitely of the running control algorithm, if one of the limits is reached, the operation of the converter is immediately stopped. Each analog channel of the B-Box RCP is then configured using the rotary button. Let's now go back to the Simulink model. The first thing to do is to configure the ADC blocks to match the parameters of the sensor that we are using, and to transfer the parameters that we've just configured on the B-Box RCP front panel. For instance, on channel 0, we can load the predefined parameters of the external voltage sensor and specify the programmable gain as 4 times. Then we do the same for the channels 1 and 2. We are now ready to generate code from the model and execute it on a B-Box RCP controller. In the configuration block, let's change the execution purpose from simulation to automatic code generation. This will replace the simulation model of the library blocks with real code instructions that will typically read or write on the real peripherals of the controller. Then, all we need to do is to click the build button. This will use Simulink Coder to generate code from the Simulink model, and then the toolchain included in ACG SDK will automatically build the code, create an executable, and launch the Imperix real-time monitoring software cockpit. From there, make sure that your controller is connected to your computer via Ethernet. This can be done either directly or through a local network. One way to connect to the controller is by entering the IP address displayed on its screen. This address can be found by simply turning the push button of the front panel at the end of the startup sequence. Once connected, Cockpit will automatically load the executable onto the controller and execute it. The B-Box RCP will display running on its front panel once this procedure is completed. Although the code runs, this doesn't mean the converter is already operating. We'll see later how to start the converter. What we can do now is to display our variables. Those are the signals of the Simulink model that are connected to a probe block and those coming from a tunable parameter block. Those variables can be logged in real time by dragging them on a scope plot or a rolling plot. Let's display the input voltage on a rolling plot, whereas the output voltage along with its reference value on a scope. The axes can be freely scaled using the panel on the right. Now, before starting the converter, I'll charge the DC bus at 200 volts. Finally, we can start the operation of the converter by clicking the displayed squared button. This will start to generate PWM outputs and thus allow power to flow in the converter. The B-Box RCP will display front panel locked, and the core LED will turn green to indicate that the converter is operating. Since the output voltage reference is still zero, there is no power flow yet. Once the reference is set to a different value, for example 100 volts, the converter starts switching, and the output voltage is controlled at 100 volts, as seen on the right plot. Similarly, when reverting the reference back to zero, the output voltage falls to zero. Now let's say we want to observe the dynamic behavior of our converter. Using the scope module, we can display each and every sample of all our variables, like we would on an oscilloscope. Let's configure a reference voltage step from 0 to 50 volts after 75 milliseconds in the acquisition window, followed by another step to 100 volts at 150 milliseconds. Then, all you need to do is click on Fire Transient, and the project view area will display the system's response. The same response can be observed with a real oscilloscope. For instance, if you'd like to observe the high-frequency current ripples with a current probe, it is required to use a real oscilloscope. In this case, you can output the voltage reference on one of the analog outputs, connect it to the oscilloscope, and trigger the oscilloscope on the rising edge of that voltage reference. This way, when you change the reference, you can observe the transient response of the system. In our case, the output voltage reference is the only input variable, but in general, any variable can be changed multiple times and at any time. Each and every displayed sample can be exported in a CSV or MAT file for a quick post-processing or directly as a MATLAB figure. These are very efficient ways of generating easily and rapidly quality experimental results for publications. More complex systems can be implemented using the same power electronics bundle. For instance, a three-phase PV inverter for grid-tied applications. All the available bundles can be checked on the Imperix website. For example, the motor drive bundle offers a ready-to-use platform to validate control techniques for high-performance variable speed drives, like field-oriented control of a permanent magnet motor. Lastly, here is a complete MMC converter, with 8 sub-modules per phase, built with the MMC test bench. The modular multi-level converter test bench is constructed in a modular fashion with Imperix power modules, so various types of multi-level inverters can be easily built. Further information about each of these examples can be found on Imperix's knowledge base, where a growing collection of free, pre-tested, and updated resources with guided examples are provided. Well, that's all for this introductory guide. Thanks for watching.